In the early morning, as you sip your cherished coffee and scroll through messages, you are suddenly met with words that feel like a splash of cold water. Perhaps a harsh comment or an unkind gesture. Instantly, your day seems dimmer. Dealing with toxic individuals is a universal challenge, yet how we react can profoundly alter the dynamics. Have you ever observed how a single negative remark can linger in your mind longer than a compliment? It's akin to a stubborn stain on your favorite shirt that defies all means of washing. But here is where your strength resides, in recognizing that stain and choosing not to let it tarnish your shirt or your day. It's about grasping what these harsh moments reveal more about the other person's inner battles and insecurities than they do about you. In his meditations, Marcus Aurelius bestowed upon us a timeless gem of wisdom. He urged, when another person blames you, hates you, or voices similar criticisms, go to their souls. Penetrate inside and see what sort of people they are. You will realize that there is no need to be racked with anxiety or that they should hold any particular opinion about you. This perspective beckons us to transcend surface interactions and comprehend the deeper motivations behind others' actions. This moment of confrontation with negativity also presents a unique opportunity for self-reflection. So I challenge you to delve inward, peeling away the layers of expectations and societal masks. What truths about yourself have been obscured by others' judgments? Are you allowing someone else's negativity to define your day or your worth? Let's embark on this journey of self-discovery together, uncovering strategies not only to cope with toxic individuals, but also to fortify our sense of self. Self-awareness. Imagine encountering someone in your life who's always seems to press all the wrong buttons. We often label these individuals as toxic because their negativity clouds our vision, making it difficult to see clearly. But what if I told you there's a way to clear the air and navigate through this fog without losing your sense of direction? It all begins with self-awareness. Just as knowing you're allergic to smoke prompts you to avoid it, understanding your reactions to toxic people can empower you to maintain emotional distance. This concept brings to mind a lesson from an ancient fencing master who taught his students that the true skill in fencing lies not just in attacking, but in knowing precisely when to evade. Each time a toxic person strikes out, envision yourself executing a flawless sidestep. You don't absorb the blow because you're aware of your own boundaries and you respect them enough not to let anyone cross. This approach doesn't necessitate anger or retaliation, but rather a calm, unwavering understanding of who you are. Incorporating this awareness into your daily life isn't as challenging as it may seem. Initially, it's akin to learning to tie your shoes, requiring focus, but eventually becoming second nature. When confronted with negativity, take a moment to step back and ask yourself, why does this bother me, or what can I learn from this? These questions aren't about excusing others' behavior, but about reinforcing your own mental resilience. Navigating through the smoke of others' negativity and cultivating self-awareness is no fairy tale. There will be days when reacting impulsively may seem easier, but such victories are hollow and fleeting as they betray your true self. Each time you choose to respond rather than react, remember that you're doing so not because it's an easy option, but because it's the right one for you. The journey is about constructing a fortress within yourself, not from a place of arrogance, but from one of strength and serenity. It's not about ignoring negativity, but rather acknowledging it without allowing it to dictate your actions. Embrace this challenge, for it sharpens you, makes you more resilient, and ultimately, undeniably stronger. Forgiveness. As you turn your gaze toward the sky, Observe how the stars shine brightly despite the encircling darkness. Consider these stars as the people who enrich your life, illuminating your path with understanding and empathy. On the other hand, you may encounter black holes, symbolic of toxic individuals who draw you into their darkness, draining you of joy and your energy. Now ponder this. Is there a way to navigate this cosmic dance of relationships without being pulled into these black holes? Envision yourself as a spaceship fueled not by hydrogen, but by courage and wisdom. This courage is your forgiveness, the power that frees you from the gravity of resentment and lifts you higher than any toxic influence. It liberates you from the chains of painful memories and grudges. Yet every spaceship requires a navigational system. This is your memory, the repository of life's lessons. It silently guides you, reminding you to veer away when a familiar black hole looms in your flight path. Our past encounters with toxicity are not shackles. They are points on a star map, guiding us towards safer orbits. Each lesson learned, each overpowering emotional felt, becomes a beacon, instructing us on what to avoid and shaping our future interactions. The fusion of forgiveness and memory serves as a compass guiding us through the intricate constellation of our relationships. With these thoughts in mind, reflect on your journey through this celestial dance. Who radiates the brilliance of star in your life? And from who do you need to divert like a black hole? Utilize forgiveness as fuel, propelling you forward, and let memory navigate, preventing you from repeating past patterns. In this intricate ballet of life, let us aspire to be the spaceship that charts its path through cosmic chaos with refined grace. Driven by the power of forgiveness and guided by the wisdom of memory, may we navigate the complexities of relationships with poise and purpose. Emotional stability. Navigating life surrounded by toxic individuals can often feel like trekking through a dense fog, where the path ahead becomes obscured and each step feels uncertain. But what if I told you there's a way to clear this fog? It begins from within, through the cultivation of emotional stability rooted in stoicism. Think about that one person who, regardless of chaos, remains unruffled, a mountain standing firm against the raging storm. This isn't about being indifferent or cold. It's about understanding that the only thing truly within our control is how we choose to respond to the external world. Stoicism teaches us that our power lies in our reaction, not in attempting to control the uncontrollable. So when confronted with toxicity, we channel our inner stoic. Instead of getting entangled in the drama, we pause. It's akin to finding ourselves in the eye of the hurricane while everything rages around us. There's a calmness within. This space grants us the opportunity to breathe, think, and then act from a place of rational composure. It involves shifting our focus from the external chaos to how we allow it to impact our inner peace. And how do we achieve this? Through the practice of mindfulness. Yes, mindfulness is often talked about these days, but here's the real essence. It works. Mindfulness enables us to detach, to observe the chaos without becoming ensnared by it. It's not about disregarding the toxicity, but rather acknowledging it without letting it dictate our peace. It's understanding that much like the clouds in the sky, these moments of negativity will also pass. So the next time you find yourself amidst such negativity, remember, you are the architect of your peace. Build it strong, anchored in the principles of emotional stability and stoicism. Boundaries. Imagine stepping into a world where every interaction is like a brushstroke on the canvas of your day. Some strokes are vibrant and uplifting, enhancing the beauty of your existence. Then there are those dark, heavy, and inconsistent strokes left by toxic people in your life. These interactions don't just leave a mark, they alter the entire masterpiece of your day, your mood, and even your self-perception. Now think about the ancient Stoics. They were the masters of their own minds, not by avoiding adversity, but by fortifying their inner walls. They understood that not every opinion, critique, or negative energy deserved their attention. What if I told you that dealing with toxic people could be approached with the same stoicism? It's not about building an impenetrable wall, but about choosing which gates to open and when. This selective openness doesn't make you less of a person, it makes you a curator of your own peace. Picture your energy as a limited precious resource, like water in a desert. Every interaction you engage in is like giving a droplet of water away. Would you rather give it to someone who plants seeds in your desert, make it bloom, or to someone who lets it evaporate under the scornful sun? Setting boundaries is about investing your energy wisely, not with arrogance or disdain, but with the calm resolve of a Stoic who knows their worth and the value of their time. It's about calmly communicating. This is where I draw the line, because your peace is not up for negotiation. So let's move forward with this mindset. View each day as an opportunity to paint your masterpiece, to invest your energy where it grows wonders. Remember, respecting yourself enough to set boundaries is not an act of aggression. It is an act of self-respect and wisdom. Start today, not by cutting the people out, but by delineating where your garden ends and where the wild begins, and watch how the landscape of your life transforms. If this resonates with you, let us know in the comments and give it a like and spread the message. And don't forget to hit subscribe for more insights. Energy intelligence. Have you ever found yourself sharing space with someone whose energy feels like a thunderstorm, turning your sunny day upside down? Navigating the choppy waters of interactions with toxic individuals can test even the calmest of minds. But let's turn the lens inward and explore this concept of energy intelligence as our compass. Think of your energy as a protective barrier, much like an ancient city wall. A force that preserves your peace and keeps out the unwelcome negativity. Now consider the power of choice in these situations. Just as you decide what fuel to put in your car, determining its performance and longevity, you hold the power to select how you react and engage with energy-draining individuals. Responding with patience and understanding, or choosing not to engage at all, can be your super fuel, optimizing your emotional well-being and keep you on a steady course. This isn't about avoiding conflict, it's about arming yourself with the wisdom and making choices that align with your peace. Harnessing this intelligence goes way beyond mere self-control. It's about creating a space around you that is so grounded, even the mightiest storm can't shake your foundation. Like a tree deeply rooted into the earth, you are immovable. Not because the wind doesn't blow you around, but because you have mastered the art of bending and swaying with it without breaking. This strength and flexibility disarm toxic energy, leaving it no choice but to dissipate or move along. Now I invite you to reflect on how you've been managing your energy in the face of adversity. Think about those moments when you felt overwhelmed by someone else's negativity. How did you respond? Did you let their storm cloud your sky? Or did you shine even brighter, guiding both of you back to calm? This journey isn't about becoming unaffected. It's about recognizing what within you lies as a reservoir of strength and wisdom, ready to face any challenge that comes your way. Pause, breathe, and remind yourself of the power you hold. Moving forward, how will you channel this energy intelligence to not just protect your peace, but also to light the way for others? Remember, the real test of your inner strength isn't how you avoid the storm, but how you dance in the rain. Goals. You know that the feeling when you've set your sights on something you truly desire, perhaps it's mastering a new skill, reaching a fitness milestone, or advancing in your personal projects. It feels like you are on a clear path, right? But then unexpectedly, you encounter people or situations that dampen your spirit. These encounters can throw you off, almost like a gust of wind redirecting a paper airplane. It's disheartening, to say the least. Take the story of Jordan, for instance. Jordan was fully committed to starting a small online business. Waves of skepticism from friends and family hit him hard. Some doubting out loud, others subtly recommending safer paths. It's a scenario many of us are familiar with. Instead of getting embroiled in fruitless debates or attempting to validate his ambitions, Jordan concentrated on refining his skills, broadening his knowledge, and building his business one step at a time. What can we learn from Jordan's journey? A steadfast belief in one's vision and a refusal to let negativity detour one's path. This segues into how we deal with toxic people. A skill that requires finesse. The Stoics were onto something profound. They focused on what is within our control. And let's face it, altering others isn't in that category. However, managing our response to them is well within our grasp. It's about maintaining a mental barrier, ensuring negativity does not penetrate and cloud our judgment or our spirits. Imagine a raincoat during a downpour. It doesn't stop the rain, but keeps you dry. That's the kind of resilience we are after. So the next time you find yourself facing skepticism or negativity regarding your plans or ambitions, think of Jordan. Redirect your energy not into convincing detractors, but into fortifying your own path. Offer a smile, a nod, and carry on with your endeavors. You have goals to meet, and no amount of negative deserves to occupy space in your thoughts without paying the rent. Embrace stoicism focused on your actions, enjoy the process, and allow the descent to become a mere whisper in the background. It is your journey, and you are the sole navigator of your path. Support. Every once in a while, we encounter someone who seems to challenge our peace of mind on every possible level. You know those people whose presence feel like a storm cloud on a sunny day. It's like being stuck in quicksand. The harder you struggle to maintain your calm, the deeper you sink into frustration and anger. This is the complex dynamic we often find ourselves in when dealing with toxic individuals. It's a test of our patience, but more importantly, of our stoicism. But let's take a closer look at how reaching out for support in these situations doesn't show weakness. It reveals wisdom. Much like how a single candle can break the darkness, sharing your struggles with someone who understands can light up paths you didn't even see before. These are the people who add strength to our resolve. Not by fighting our battles for us, but by reminding us of the power of our own mental fortitude. Imagine having a wise elder in your corner, offering advice drawn from a well of experience. That's the kind of invaluable support that can help us navigate through toxicity with grace. To harness the Stoic strength within us, we need to recognize when external perspectives can assist us. It's about understanding that while we cannot control the actions of others, we can certainly control our reactions to them. Through the art of Stoicism, we learn to detach, to see the situation from a higher perspective. It's like zooming out on a map to find alternative routes we might have missed while being zoomed in. In seeking support, we allow ourselves a space to breathe, reflect, and choose our responses carefully, ensuring that they align with our values and our sense of peace. Now take a moment to think about your own encounters with challenging individuals. How have you navigated these waters? Have you tried to go it alone, relying solely on your strength, or have you reached out for that supportive perspective that could change everything? Remember, the true mark of a stoic isn't in silence or solitary suffering, but in knowing when and how to engage the wisdom around us to walk the path with greater ease and understanding. Self-talk. Remember the first time you crossed paths with someone whose energy felt like a rain cloud on a parade? We've all been there, feeling the weight of someone else's negativity pulling us down. Surprisingly, the way we talk to ourselves when dealing with toxic people can either be our armor or our Achilles heel. Think of your mind like a garden and every thought about yourself as a seed. Planting seeds of strength and resilience help us all stand tall, but sprinkle in doubts and fears, and those toxic weeds start to choke out all of the good. But that's just part of the story. Walking away isn't always an option, but here's where the ancient wisdom of Stoicism steps in. It's not about what happens to us, but how we react to it. Stoicism enlightens us that true strength is found in our reactions. Thus, when navigating through the turbulence of someone else's negative influence, carefully monitor the conversations you have with yourself instead of asking, "Why do I have to deal with this?" Consider pondering, "How can I grow from this encounter?" It may cultivate resilience, empathy, or the courage to uphold your boundaries. Altering your viewpoint is not merely playing with semantics, it's reclaiming your power. Another tool at your disposal. That little but powerful thing called detachment. Not cold, not uncaring, just wisely choosing where your energy goes. Imagine someone's negative comments as arrows. Now, if your self-worth is an impenetrable shield, those arrows cannot touch you. This doesn't mean you won't feel the sting sometimes, but remember, those arrows can only wound you if you let them in. So take a moment to reflect. How often do you let external negativity influence your self-talk? Controlling this doesn't mean building a fortress around your heart. It's about knowing your worth, understanding that your reaction is your power, and sometimes simply deciding not to give your peace away. Stoicism isn't about an emotional existence, but choosing which battles are worth your heartbeats. Remember, the only person you really have control over in this life is you. Solutionable approach. Do you ever find yourself wondering how to handle those inevitable encounters with toxic people? It's like navigating through a dense fog where every step feels uncertain and the air feels heavy. The key here is adopting a solution-oriented mindset deeply rooted in the principles of Stoicism. This approach sets the stage for us to transform these interactions into opportunities for personal growth and emotional intelligence, rather than sources of frustration. As you might imagine, flipping the script on toxic encounters requires creativity. It's like playing chess. You need to think of several moves ahead, anticipating reactions without becoming emotionally entangled. This means listening more than you speak and responding with calmness, a trait admired by many but mastered by few. This strategic creativity enables you to maintain your peace and not get pulled into the chaos. Adaptability in these situations is your best friend. It's the ability to remain true to your values while navigating the challenge of interacting with difficult personalities. Imagine you're a tree. Firm in your roots, yet flexible in the wind. You sway but do not break when faced with the gales of toxicity. This resilience strengthens your character and equips you with the tools to face any storm. Now I invite you to reflect. How do you react when confronted with negativity or manipulation? Remember, the presence of toxic people might not be within your control, but how you respond is. By incorporating a stoic, solution-oriented mindset, you're not just avoiding the pitfalls of negativity, you're actively shaping a life of peace, resilience, and dignity. Remember, in the grand scheme of things, it's not the obstacles we face, but how we overcome them that define us. Argument navigation. Choose your battles wisely. That's a piece of advice as old as time. But it's never been more relevant than in today's world, where every interaction can feel like a minefield. When dealing with toxic people, it's like navigating a maze in the dark. You never know when you might bump into a wall. The key here is not to charge at every wall you encounter, but to feel your way around and decide which paths are worth taking. Some conflicts are just dead ends. Energy drainers with no exit or treasure at the end. Recognizing this can save you a lot of headaches. You'll be surprised to learn that sometimes the most powerful thing you can do is not react at all. Silence can be louder than any word you might throw into the fray. When toxic people aim their negativity at you, they're often looking for a reaction, a sign that their words have hit home. By choosing not to engage, you're taking the wind out of their sails. It's not about ignoring the problem, but about choosing not to let it control you. Your energy is precious. Spend it on the battles that matter. Beware of the trap of trying to change someone's toxic behavior by arguing or reasoning with them. It's like trying to put out a fire with gasoline. It only fuels the flames. Instead, ask reflective questions to encourage them to see the situation from a different perspective. It's about shifting from confrontation to conversation. This approach won't work every time, and that's okay. The goal isn't to win every battle with them, but to maintain your peace and dignity in the process. On the battlefield, empathy is your shield and patience your sword. Trying to understand where the other person is coming from doesn't mean you agree with them or condone their behavior. It means you're strong enough to look beyond the surface. Remember, everyone is fighting their own battles, some of which you know nothing about. By practicing patience, you give yourself time to respond rather than to react. This doesn't make you weak, it makes you very, very wise. I'm inviting you to take a moment and reflect on your encounters with difficult people. Are there patterns you notice? Are there battles you've been fighting that are simply not worth your time? Remember, being stoic isn't about being emotionless. It's about not allowing your emotions to control you. It's about choosing where to focus your energy, knowing not every battle is yours to win. So the next time you're faced with a potential argument, take a step back, breathe, and ask yourself, is this really worth my peace? False intentions. Isn't it shocking how quickly a simple discussion can escalate into a full-blown argument? It's like a small spark turning into a wildfire, destroying everything in its path. But here's the thing. Not every spark has to turn into a fire, especially when dealing with toxic people. Understanding the concept of false cordiality can be your fire extinguisher. It's about recognizing when someone's pretending to be on your side while silently stacking the wood to feed the flames. Body language does not lie. A grin that doesn't light up their eyes or arms crossed tightly across their chest are telltale signs of insincerity. A subtle clue that you're dealing with hidden agendas, not genuine concern. Pause for a moment and listen to what's not being said. A voice dripping with honey but lacking warmth, or an awkward laugh that seems to jar with the flow of conversation, can reveal more than words ever could. These nuances of communication are like invisible threads pulling at your intuition, tugging you towards the realization that all is not as it seems. Now think about the patterns you notice in people's behaviors. Consistent actions reveal a person's true character. On the other hand, behavior that swings wildly based on who's watching is as flimsy as a leaf in the wind, signifying that the show of friendship is just that, a show. It's crucial to observe these patterns, for in the realm of human interactions, consistency is king. Being able to sift through the facades of false cordiality is not just about safeguarding yourself against toxic relationships, it's about cultivating an environment where authentic relationships can flourish. It's about being a beacon of authenticity in a sea of pretense, guiding others towards the shores of genuine connections. So next time you sense that something is off, trust your gut, pay attention to the signs, and remember, not every hand extended in friendship is one worth shaking. Stay steadfast, for the path ahead is yours alone. Remember, your peace is a fortress. Guard it with the wisdom of stoicism. Exploring stoicism offers the chance to not only handle toxic individuals, but also to lead to a more fulfilling life.